Namaskar. Welcome to Simplify Your Space. Lockdown scrambled a lot of us, including me, to look for help in technology and equipment. More so now when I'm getting used to running my household without any house help, it is prudent to invest into machines that simplify my routine. Dishwasher was one such machine that was not so popular at Indian households, but suddenly shot up into such great demand that it started commanding a waiting period. Like sanitizer, many dishwasher manufacturers mushroomed overnight to fill the demand supply gap. Though it is common machine in the West, in India, demand made it look like berozgar machine ki sarkari naukri lag gayi hai. We also bought one from LG. In today's video, I would be talking about this machine which I have been using for the last 2 months. And at the end, I shall also tell you whether it's worth buying a dishwasher or not, be it from any brand, so that it can help you to make the right decision. This video is not sponsored from LG, though I wished it was. I've paid for it and happy to share my unbiased review on this product. Let's get started. So when the lockdown was eased, initially we booked a Bosch dishwasher but didn't get its delivery for 2 months. Obviously due to very high demand and disrupted supply lines almost in all the sectors. Then we cancelled our booking with Bosch and booked one with LG. This time we got it within a week time and this is how it looks. It has beautiful steel grey premium finish with a soft touch panel. It opens up like this. It has two racks with 14 place setting. Best part is both the racks have foldable plate racks, which means you can use them as per your need. If there are no plates, you can easily close them and make a rack flat. Very useful for washing big vessels and cookware. At the bottom, it has four washing arms. And here in the middle, two with sprinklers on both the sides. Fixed sprinklers on the top and at the door help in better cleaning. Here at the bottom, a compartment is used to fill up the salt and soften the water to improve detergent's efficiency. When salt finishes after a few days, the dishwasher gives the indication to refill it again. Here on the door, there are two compartments, one for detergent and the other one for rinse it. I will talk more about this later in the video. Beautiful and elegant touch panel has power button along with 9 wash programs: auto, turbo, eco, gentle, quick, refresh, etc. It also has features like true steam, where you can sanitize your utensils well, high temperature wash, and extra dry, with which all the utensils will come out clean and dry. You may also choose the option to use half load if dishes are less for less water and power consumption. Auto mode is the longest cycle of 3.5 hours and is best suitable for mixed type of load where heavy and less soiled dishes, both types can be washed together. Otherwise, you can choose the cycle as per your preference. Lightly used utensils can be washed in express or turbo cycle, which are shorter cycles. Now before I show you how it actually cleans, let me show you what all essentials a dishwasher needs. It needs a salt, and you have already seen its compartment, dishwashing detergent, mostly Finish, Fortune and IFP are popular ones, but there are other brands as well. It comes in both powder and tablet forms. Then you need rinse it for shiny utensils and to prevent the water spots. Now let's see a real demo. I'm doing a mixed load today. Placing a used chopping board first, then use plates. Cooker is next here. A kadai. This is a cutlery rack which came along with the dishwasher. It helps to store spoons, ladles, whiskers, etc. Cooker's lid, see it's heavily soiled. On the top rack, I'm placing used teacups and glasses. Milk pan, and there is cream on the sides. Tea pan. frying pan. This is medium soiled. Some utensils are being placed in empty spaces. It is always recommended to clear all the food and rinse the utensils before putting them into dishwasher. Now filling up the detergent here, and in this compartment rinse it. Door is closed and I opt for the auto mode, which is 3.5 hours long. So the cycle is over. Let's see how it cleaned. Let's see the top rack first. See the teapot, frying pan, fully clean and shiny. Milk vessel. All the cups are nicely cleaned. Let's see the bottom rack now. See the chopping board? Cutlery also nicely cleaned. See the tea strainers? As good as new. And these strainers are almost 1 year old. Cooker and its lid, which was heavily soiled. This is the kadhai. And plates. As easy as plug and play. Neatly cleaned, sanitized and dried as well. All the utensils can go directly into the cabinets for storage. Now let me give you another demo. Here I am placing these chimney baffle filters, which are heavily soiled with oil, and cleaning them is time consuming. Also placing this food processor, which was used for kneading a dough, along with few other utensils. This time I am placing this detergent tablet. It is recommended to place the tablet at the bottom of the lower rack instead of putting it in the detergent compartment. And let's see how it works. And now, can you see everything is superbly cleaned? Filters are sparkling clean. The food processor also got cleaned nicely. So this is before and this is after. I think this machine does its job effectively and neatly. So if you have been doing dishes manually yourself, this machine will be a great help. It was a great relief for my husband. Yes, it comes with a high initial cost. I paid around 59,000 for this particular model and brand, but cheaper options are also available starting from 25,000. Another big advantage is that it removes the dependency on outside help. And more than that, you can ask it to work whenever you want to. Odd hours, extra hours are no more a limitation. More flexibility to your schedule. Almost noise-free operation, you may just hear a minor water spray sound. It uses considerably less water as compared to manual hand wash. It not only cleans but sanitizes the utensils and keeps their shine maintained. Wi-Fi capability helps you to keep a track of wash cycles, machine maintenance, and smart diagnosis using LG Think app. Utensils only made with steel, ceramic, glass, and high-grade plastic can be used. It is not suitable for utensils made with iron, aluminium, nonstick, and wood. Regular maintenance and cleaning are required in all the dishwashers. The automatic cycles are long, so if you have limited utensils at home, you need to plan the wash cycles or need to keep the backup utensils. Like other appliances, it runs on electricity. No electricity, no dishes. Its detergent and other essentials required are costlier than regular dishwashing detergent or liquid. Supply cost for essentials like detergent, salt, and rinse aid for a month, say about 60 to 80 wash cycles, would be about ₹800 to 1000. So that was all about our LG dishwasher. Personally, I would say this was one of my best decisions to buy this dishwasher. So far, pretty happy with it. It has really lowered the burden of hand washing the utensils. If you are planning to buy a dishwasher, go for it. Either LG or brand of your choice. It is useful and worth buying. Thank you for watching. Please give a thumbs up if you like this video and share it with your family and friends. Do subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram and Facebook for all the latest updates and video notifications. We'll see you all next week. Happy organizing from Simply Fire Your Space. Bye-bye.